To hear more from you about your experience with Dementia Act as well. Thank you, Carl. So our third speaker for this evening is Dr. Christopher Dayton. Chris and I actually met last Monday at the Hacking Health Toronto Ideathon, which was held at the Mall Centre, and actually you came in the top three, didn't you, with your ER passport idea. So, but Chris is also has travelled extensively to South America and has a particular passion there, and therefore founded and now set up the medical services trip, which I hope you are going to talk a little bit about. Interesting to hear. You're actually in Toronto, aren't you, and work in KW. So, Chris is used to the corridor between the two. So without further ado, Chris, I'd like to invite you up.
Can everyone hear me okay? I've got a loud voice, so should work out all right. Okay, thanks everyone for coming. So this talk has nothing at all to do with pretty boring, so it's a complete left turn here into the world of global health. So I'm an eMERGE doc at Grand River, so I'm actually working the night shift tonight. All right, so this is a pitch for my startup, which is QuickChart EMR. It's part of the large organization, which is a research organization called Medical Service Trip, which relates to better practices and short-term volunteering. So really what I'm hoping for from you guys is some really harsh, uncomfortable feedback. So I want you guys to absolutely demolish this pitch. It's about 5 minutes in length. Right now I've got to narrow this down, refine this to a solid 3 minutes for a pitch I'm doing in Hong Kong in August. So so here we go. So picture EMR. So first of all, I want you to picture yourself as a doctor. And you're working in the middle of remote Guatemala in the mountains. And you're seeing a patient, and this patient has a fever. You've got a medical student with you. The medical student leans over and says, "Do you think that this could be chikungunya?" Would you know how to answer that medical student? And I certainly wouldn't have. And I'm not sure that I do even right now, even though I'm an emergency doctor, even though I've done this for the last 7 years or so. And that was part of the inspiration for me developing this QuickChart EMR app that I'm going to talk about. So, like I mentioned, so like many, many doctors, I've done a lot of volunteering abroad over the last few years. And the problem is really twofold. So first of all, these trips are enormously expensive. They can cost $11,000 a week in opportunity costs if you're a physician. The second problem is that a lot of these medical projects are very, very poorly done. So just because you might be a physician who's spectacular working in Toronto, working in the developed world, doesn't mean you have any idea how to practice in that remote mountain village. And the idea of having electronic medical records in that kind of setting is virtually impossible. So here's why some of these medical projects are actually quite shady. So number one, as I mentioned, these clinicians often don't know what they're doing. Number two, their diagnoses are often ambiguous because you have no diagnostic tests, you have no previous records. And third, the infrastructure makes these traditional EMRs impossible. So these problems, they affect volunteers, who I'm going to focus on, but they also affect field workers, community health workers, agri-docs, local doctors in these settings. And these problems apply not only to these remote areas, to villages, but they also apply to conflict, disaster-affected zones. So what did we do? We prototyped a mobile electronic medical records app that's designed for clinicians who are working in exactly these kinds of settings. And we integrated the kind of life-saving information that medical professionals, agri-docs, community health workers would need at the point of care. And we called it QuickChart EMR.
So how is this different?
So
So first of all, it's an EMR that you can pick up, you can use it immediately without booking your 4 p.m. training session with IT. You can use this immediately. Second, it puts these guidelines for common illnesses right in the hands of clinicians, right in the faces of clinicians. And third, you can do all this offline if you need to, in this remote mountain village. And then you can upload your files opportunistically when you finally get back to a setting that has a Wi-Fi connection. So how big is medical volunteering? It's absolutely huge. So depending on who you ask, about a quarter to a third of medical students will volunteer abroad at some point during their training. Among practicing doctors, 15-20% will volunteer abroad annually, at least in the US. And the research arm of this project is actually our directory of NGOs that operate medical projects in Latin America. So right now we have around 350. That's almost certainly a vast underestimate of the number. So we've been beta testing the prototype over the last year. So that's also the non-paid version of the app. It's been doing pretty well on Google Play. We've got a net promoter score of 52 among the beta testers. And we actually now have our first 4 clients for the cloud version of the app, which is coming soon, which is in mid-development right now. So we're planning to operate this as a freemium app, so a freemium business model. Anyone can download the app for free, anyone can use the guidelines for free, play around with making medical records, but the NGOs will need credits to access the advanced features and the cloud support aspect of the app. So we're going to gamify this credit system. So there are many ways to obtain the credits. So you can just buy them, or you can have your charitable supporters support you by donating these credits. Or you can support our research by completing surveys that support our research and development goals. How are we going to market this? So we've got relationships again with all these 350 currently NGOs that are in our database. The marketing is going to be direct to those organizations. And on top of that, we're also very active in the research world, so we're building awareness and building health conferences. And as far as the barriers to entry, we own the source code here. That's number one. We're the ones who are developing from the ground up these clinical guidelines, these truncated guidelines that are specifically designed for resource-limited settings, based on the protocols from the NGOs and also based on WHO, World Health Organization standards. And as I mentioned before, we have the largest directory in existence of medical missions in Latin America, and we have relationships with many of these NGOs as well. So a few other competing players. So the most significant one is probably Backpack EMR. The main difference is that those guys are web-based. The second thing is that their service is broader, targeted towards surgical missions, not just primary care. And they also don't include any clinical guidelines. The only other significant app player, as you can see there, is Notes First, and they're for iOS, we're for Android. Here's our team. Each of us has a picture of our Canadian developer, that's not actually here. So my partner has a PhD, she's got a lot of research experience. Also experience with healthcare startups, with technological startups. We've also been building up a team of consultants as well. So we have a business development consultant called Market Grade. We have local doctors in the developing world, so a Peruvian doc, Ugandan doc, we're helping out, and also people with experience in conflict-affected settings. We're still working on narrowing down these financials and the confidence limits for these numbers, so we're using the stats from our database and experience with the research. And we're trying to work out the best and worst case scenarios for the credit-based system. And so here's our ask. So we didn't have an ask before, now we do. We're a very lean startup. We're bootstrapping it, but we need money to accelerate the program. So our first big need is money for iOS development and for the web app development to improve the website and to integrate things with the smartphone app. Our second need is that we're looking for support for marketing, so marketing dollars, to target NGOs and the volunteers. And then the other thing we're looking for is clinicians who can help out with beta testing this app, and also reviewing, with the appropriate experience, reviewing the clinical guidelines that are present in the app as well.
And then if you don't have money, you can also support us. If you've been a previous volunteer who's volunteered abroad, you can rate one of the NGOs in our big database that we have at medicalservicetrip.com. Or if not, you can always just follow us on social media. All right. So. Yes.
April, do I have access to your chart?
Absolutely. Okay. And that's part of the beauty of it.